Notification supports the idea of a group of delivery endpoints. So for example, I can create a brand new group. Let me just call this my group one. That group can contain individual endpoints of individual contacts, or it can contain just specific delivery endpoints that are standalone, or it can contain other groups, existing groups, to do kind of nesting. We also support escalation teams. We'll talk more about that in just a minute. But for example, if I search for, how about all of the, I think we had a few contacts that begin with the name solution. Yeah, there we go. Now, most of these have delivery endpoints. See, this is what we're adding here are delivery endpoints, not contacts. So if you notice, some of these folks, they don't have an email associated with them. I cannot add them to this. Let's see. I'll go ahead and select that. Say OK. And now we'll just continue to do that for all of the, this is going to be all the delivery endpoints that we're trying to find. Now let's look at solution JHOG. There we go. Now, as I said, we could also add existing groups or escalation groups. We can also, or these escalation teams, we can add delivery endpoints that are standalone. They can all become part of this group. Now, when you configure this group, you can specify how many acknowledgments are required. If you specify auto, that simply means that there are no acknowledgments required. It's going to auto acknowledge. And then you'll get this number here that's going to be equal to the number of current delivery endpoints you have. So for example, if I add another one, you'll notice that we don't just have one and two anymore. We've got one, two, or three. So in other words, I can specify as many acknowledgments required as I need. Let's just go with this. Here we go. As you can see now, I can specify either just one acknowledgement or all three of them have to be acknowledging this, or two as well. So that's a group. Now, one thing I want to point out is you can add to this group, you can add the contacts that are themselves groups within Active Directory. If you recall, with the proper configuration of notifications, you can specify these groups, these Active Directory groups. And if they're associated with a delivery endpoint, then you can add them to this group. So if you've got an Active Directory group, and let's say there are 15 people, is this number here going to go to 15? Well, no, that's not an option that we have there. You know, we cannot specify or break out that we're waiting for X number out of all the group, all the members of the group in Active Directory. We view that, we do send the notification to everybody in that group, but we can only retrieve back one acknowledgement. So that's not going to be something that you can break out on an individual basis if you're making reference to the Active Directory groups. Now you're going to notice in just a second we're going to talk about these escalation teams. So okay, what's the difference? Why the difference between group? What's the difference between a team and a group? Well, the group is going to get the notification all at once at the same time. An escalation team is going to, you know, proceed through an escalation pattern that we'll look at in our next video.